Anderson ticket, talking Mazda for the figures. That's a comma and a comma and a comma. Gotta get it, get it.
Anderson ticket, talking Mazda for the figures. That's a comma and a comma and a comma. Gotta get it. I'm a comma and a comma and a comma. Gotta get it, get it, get it, get it. Comma and a comma. Gotta get it, get it. Anderson ticket, talking Mazda for the figures. That's a comma and a comma and a comma. Gotta get it. I'm a comma and a comma and a comma. Gotta get it, get it, get it, get it. Comma and a comma. Gotta get it. Talking Mazda for the biggest. That's a comma and a comma and a comma. Gotta get it. I'm a comma and a comma and a comma. Gotta get it, get it, get it, get it. Comma and a comma. Gotta get it, get it. And it's a ticket. Talking Mazda for the biggest. That's a comma and a comma and a comma. Gotta get it. I'm a comma and a comma and a comma. Gotta get it, get it, get it, get it. Comma and a comma. Gotta get it, get it. Talking Mazda for the biggest. That's a comma and a comma and a comma. Gotta get it. I'm a comma and a comma and a comma. Gotta get it, get it, get it, get it. Comma and a comma. Gotta get it, get it. And it's a ticket. Talking Mazda for the biggest. That's a comma and a comma and a comma. Gotta get it. I'm a comma.
Hello, my name is Robert Solveld, and we are back to another Friday. It goes so fast. It's already July the 24th, 2020. Watching the news, one might get confused. There is so much going on. Countries that used to be the leading countries, like the United States of America, it's unbelievable what a chaos is being projected. But we're not going to be political today. We're going to be observing what it is to live in an imperfect world. And how can we survive? How can we obtain a level of living for ourselves, for our family, for our loved ones? And that is why tough times never last. Tough people do. And how do we do that? One of the things I discuss in my book, and the book title is Deception Protocol for the Prodigal Son, a blueprint, is basically the PMS. PMS stands for a Lumi's disease, I understand, but it also stands for politics, money, and spirituality. See, there is a beautiful book, and I call it the early book that is written, a manual written before you leave Earth. And it is called the Bible. The Bible talks about, in the last book of Revelations, about three lying spirits. And those spirits are money, politics, and spirituality. If there is anything we know and we most likely agree, is that politics is in shambles at the moment. Nobody really knows what to do, and they're all trying something else. Second of all, money. I don't think I have to explain much about the banks making billions of dollars, a couple of billionaires standing on top of the world, and they are owning everything. That doesn't make sense. But now spirituality. I know out of personal experience, it hasn't been fun for me, what I have experienced. But I learned a few things out of it all. And that means that we do have a foundation. And if the foundation is solid, we can stand on it. But what is that foundation? The foundation is Yeshua HaMashiach. Now, I know that some people know him as Jesus Christ. But if we go back to then, in the time that he was born, if he would have been called Jesus, he wouldn't even have looked around, because his name was Yeshua HaMashiach. And knowing that, we also understand that there were some guidelines given to us. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness. And you see, as a child, I was always curious, what does this really mean? And I always fell for it, and I had to ask the question.
Thank you for calling.
Who are
Please
those
leave a message.
Virgins? They're talking about five wise virgins and five foolish ones. Who were the foolish ones? And they always told me it had to do with how you behave, what you did, blah, 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 blah. You know, I am 70 years of age now. That started when I was 10 years old. So that is 60 years that thought has been in my mind. Who are those virgins, the wise ones? See, for a long time I was told, and I believed that it had to do how I behaved, how I did this, how I did that, etc., etc. But reality is, it has nothing to do with it. See, it is the love of God that shines through me. As He is the potter and I'm the clay, what is put in me is the love of God. And Yeshua HaMashiach says that we will be recognized through the love of God. And as churches are bickering and fighting each other and making sure that they are on the millionaires or billionaires list as the richest pastor or preacher or whatever, they're missing the point. The point is that God's name is honored. And honoring can mean a simple woman knocking on the door and saying, "Are you okay? I baked something for you. I noticed that you're not coming out as often to buy groceries. Do you have enough groceries?" And they hand you a bag with groceries, or they hand you a home-baked pie or a home-baked meal. Isn't that wonderful? That is the love of God. And if that love shines through you, that people are attracted to you because of His love, that is the light shining. Not how well we talk, how well we preach, how well we show up who we are. I am nothing. But His name is everything. And if that comes through and my oozes out of my system, out of my body, out of my lifestyle, unfortunately, I didn't know that for a long time. And I fell for all those things. You had to be good, you had to behave, you had to well work hard, you had to make lots of money. But now that I'm 70, I coined the phrase #70. I am 40 years old. And I've got 30 years experience of being 40. And in that time, it finally dawned on me, it's the love of God that shines through me. That is the light. If God recognizes, then there's a statement that will be ready for you as well. Well done, you good and faithful servant. Please remember, living in the times like this is not easy. I'm not preaching at you, I'm sharing what I had to learn the hard way. And when I say hard, I mean hard. But you know, the love of God is unbelievable. When love shines through your life, when you act in love, God's love can work through you. That is the light shining out of your lemon. That will be true, whether you are one of the 5 wise virgins or the 5 foolish ones. And remember, tough times never last, but tough people do. God bless you. Bye for now.